Hello everybody, welcome to this week's episode. This week we will go through more about Shiba Inus. This week we have a very special guest. His name is Ryuichi. He is Japan imported. So currently now he is our best awarded Shiba Inu. Actually best awarded Shiba Inu in Singapore. So what happened is he has 2017-2018 best Shiba of the year in Singapore. He has an international champion, grand champion, Asia Pacific champion, and Singapore champion. So he is now retired already. Okay, we got 4 points to cover. The first point is actually grooming and maintenance of the coat. The second point is weather and climate and living environment. Number three is intake and supplements. And number four is actually their bloodline and genetics. Okay, so now we will cover grooming and maintenance. So firstly, grooming, we will always shower them once a week. It can be up to 2 weeks. Usually this amount is actually because of Singapore climate, Singapore weather. It's very humid. So usually a lot of people will think that you don't need to dry them fully. The reason why we want them to be dry is because number one, bacteria and parasites love wet, moist area. And then because the dog's temperature, body temperature is warm, it's actually warm and moist. So that's where bacteria really, really love to go into. Okay, so speaking about bacteria, so we will actually highly recommend this Silver Collider Spray. The reason why we recommend Silver Collider Spray is actually because this spray, when you spray, it doesn't feel like there won't be a burning sensation. So it's a lot better to use it for dogs, because when dogs feel the burning sensation, for example from alcohol and all that, they will feel the need to go and scratch it or bite it because they are uncomfortable. So Silver Collider Spray, when you spray it on wounds, it actually feels a lot more like putting water on the wound. So they won't feel so terrible, and then it kills bacteria very well. So that's why we will recommend Silver Collider. Okay, next will be climate and weather. So what happened is this climate, weather and environment, there are some things we cannot change. There are some things that we can try our best to accommodate to their fur type. So what happened is, if you look at Shiba Inu history, of course in Japan as well, during winter they are very, very fluffy. Or you know, there are Shiba Inus in even colder countries and they will be even more fluffy, maybe 3 to 5 times the fur length, and even more fluffy, 3 to 5 times more fluffy. So you can take a look, when I visited Japan, I wore a very, very thick jacket because it's very cold there. And then you can take a look at the puppies there when we visited the Shiba Kennel at Japan. They are really a lot more fluffy than Singapore. So of course we only can do what we can. We can't change the weather, we can't change the climate in Singapore. So what we do is actually, okay, the key is the cooler their environment is, the more fluffy they will be. So that is a way that they adapt to the environment. So Shiba fur coat actually is a very good thing, that they actually will shed to adapt to the environment. So if our environment is warm and hot, they will shed more. If our environment is cool, they will shed less. So Ryuichi stays in the aircon most of the time. We usually give him a dog bed, so that if he's cold, he will go to the bed. And dog bed also will help a lot on their elbows, where they don't use their elbows to get up and down and have abrasion near the elbow area. So the fur in the elbow will be also more fluffy. Usually for our recommendation is that at home, of course you cannot on, most of us, you know, we don't on the aircon for 24 hours for our dog, even if we leave our house. So what happened is we usually encourage you to bring your dog to your room when you're on the aircon, or when you're using your aircon, you can share with your dog. When you are out of your house, you can make sure that the place is well ventilated and cool. So that is one of the very important factors that we really suggest when it comes to having a fluffy coat. Okay, next will be supplement and food intake, which we will elaborate more on our next video. Ryuichi, he's currently having K9 Natural Freeze-Dried Raw Meat and Purina Pro Plans Kibbles. So we are quite simple with their diet. We don't really like to change their diet as well, so we don't want them to learn to start to get very picky. So for us, our diet is quite fixed. Anything else other than this normal diet is actually training. So when they have treats or when they have anything else, it's actually training. So they have to work for it. So the last point is actually genetic and bloodline. So it's a point that we can't eliminate because this is also very important, as sometimes, you know, like sometimes even human, when we are born with lesser hair, finer hair, it's just how we are. So this part, of course, we can't change much. So very importantly, we will look at more of the things that we can change, like grooming, their environment and their intake. For bloodline and genetics, we can't really change, but of course it still holds a very important role. So currently we have already gone through these four very important points, which we will elaborate more in our future videos. Thank you very much for watching all the way to the end. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe and share. And also let us know what are the next content that you want us to do, so we can provide better videos for you guys. Thank you so much and bye bye.